Hey, what's up guys? The Lone Top 10s here with another awesome video just for you. In the 200 or so years that mankind has been arranging and grouping elements, we have discovered 118 of them, and we have figured out what most of them are good for. Oxygen is for breathing, obviously. Helium is for having a good time without getting the police involved. Gold is for hip-hop arts, and curium is for something, apparently. Some elements, however, can be used in alternative and often surprising ways. So guess what guys, here are the 10 elements with surprising applications. Now I just want to let you know, for whatever I say that is not going to be considered, like, for example, phosphorus. Don't play around with phosphorus because I'll tell you guys later on in the video, just for you. Alright, we're going to start off with number 10. Copper has antimicrobial properties. Something pretty good. Alright, well, something like that. Let me take a look here. Antimicrobial properties. Alright. So, long ago, even before man knew what science was, they knew that copper would kill things that would kill you. That weird fuzzy thing grown in the water would meet its demise at the hands of copper. Ancient Egyptian texts say copper was used to clean wounds, sterilize water, and treat a variety of other ailments such as burns, headaches, weird growths, and leg ulcers, which are all pretty bad. Today, studies have observed that copper does indeed kill bacteria in the awesomely named process of contact killing, which is even more awesome is the actual process of contact killing. Studies suggest that when bacteria comes in contact with copper surface, the bacterial membrane ruptures, like ruptures apart, and copper ions enter the bacteria and disrupt life processes until they die. Copper and its alloys are now known for their danger to microbes, and such as continue to see use in this day. And they just doorknobs and other soft things that a lot of people come into contact with. Just think about it. So, copper is essentially better for you, so that it can kill all that crappy bacteria that everyone has. So, number 9. Phosphorus can be used as a deadly weapon. Phosphorus is famous for almost literally nothing. It's used in matches and fertilizer, but that seems to be about it. The military, however, believed that phosphorus had yet achieved its full potential, or had not yet, please excuse, whatever I just said, had not yet achieved its full potential as an element. Enter white phosphorus. White phosphorus is made from a common allotrope of the element, and it is very, very deadly. Do not come in contact with it. It was used in Vietnam, where it got the nickname Willy Pete, which in turn came from military jargon. It rapidly oxidizes and ignites, which burns like hell. It ignites fuel, clothes, ammunition, and burns deeply into your skin. It's a subject of lots of controversy and intense debate. Some feel that it should be classified as a chemical weapon, and therefore banned. It was used in Iraq, most notably in Fallujah, and supposedly more recently in Gaza and the Ukraine. However, white phosphorus is not used exclusively as a weapon and can be used in tracer routes and smoke screens because of the amount of smoke it produces. So, just think about it. Don't come in contact. Number 8. Arsenic can detect tumors. Well, we all know arsenic is very dangerous and you should never mess around with that. The world has been cracking down on lots of arsenic and its toxic properties lately, which is a huge step up from using it as wallpaper and poisoning everyone in your home. The people who are generally in charge of making sure people do not die all agree that arsenic is very bad and it's not good. It would seem that arsenic is taking a second chance. Now, research has come to light revealing that the arsenic-74 isotope can be used to detect tumors in your brain. In a paper published in 2012, a team of researchers crammed as many scientific-sounding words as they could onto one piece of paper. Now, upon further perusal of said paper, it is said that arsenic-74 isotopes were able to produce clear images of liver tumors found in rats. And please excuse me for whatever said brain tumors, it's actually liver tumors found in rats. The paper then concludes that arsenic has potential and is being researched further to see if it's safe for humans, and that their doctors will not kill them while detecting tumors. Anyway. Number 7. Sulfur is used in winemaking. This is very interesting. So, if you ever smell anything foul like the smell of alcohol, it's probably because of sulfur. Rotten eggs, skunks, and even your body odor are all caused by sulfur. The pungent substance is not something you want to be around with, because... look, it smells disgusting. That is why some people decided it was a good idea to use it to make wine, so that way kids will not drink it. Now, sulfur dioxide has been used in winemaking since the 1400s, and possibly earlier. Roman winemakers would burn sulfur candles in their wine barrels when transporting them to preserve the wine, and a Prussian decree in 1487 allowed the use of sulfur dioxide in winemaking. Sulfur dioxide is a pungent gas that has antimicrobial properties. It kills any sort of yeast that might grow in the barrel and turn the wine to literally vinegar, which is something that nobody wants. A 10% solution of potassium nonobisulfate is added to wine, and the sulfur just does its thing. If you think that this is just some arson hipster thing, rest assured that it's not, and it's actually a common practice in the winemaking industry. So, guess what, adults? If you're drinking wine, you smell that nasty stuff, just say it's sulfur. Number 6. Gallium can detect neutrinos, I think that's how you say it. Anyway, gallium is that one element that melts literally in your hand. It was a source of amazement and wonder in the days of grade school. So, what could one element with the melting point of a popsicle have to do with the neutrinos, one of the least understood aspects of the universe? Well, scientists have been trying to understand neutrinos since they were discovered. They behave like electrons but without a charge, since they're so hard and small to detect. So, scientists need to know how to find them because they can help understand the universe. Researchers studying neutrinos had a tank filled with 101 tons of gallium trichloride hydrochloric acid, and this mixture contained 30 tons of gallium. The researchers then worked their science magic and used neutrinos to induce nuclear reactions. The gallium was transmitted into germanium and then converted to germanium. Well, when they detected the decay of the germanium with a counter, they noticed that the decay agreed with earlier studies made about neutrinos. Each detected decay corresponded with each detected neutrino. Very interesting. Number 5. Cesium is used in atomic clocks. Atomic clocks are probably the most accurate clocks in the entire world. The time on your phone and on your computer is probably synced to an atomic clock somewhere. Atomic clocks make sure that the world runs smoothly enough. If you were just in time to watch WrestleMania on TV or your favorite Jeopardy show, thank the atomic clocks. Alright, the standard time in the United States is provided by cesium, an element you have probably never heard of, and you'll forget about it shortly after reading this article. Before you forget, atomic clocks are powered by locking an electric oscillator to the frequency of an atomic transition. Since transitions are stable and constant, they make for a very good measurement of time. During the cycles of the cesium atoms, they will reach a frequency of approximately 9,192,631,770 Hz. They pass through a microwave field with an almost exact frequency, and any cesium atoms that receive the energy change their energy state. A magnetic field separates the atoms, and those with the correct energy state are detected by a detector. The output peaks and is used to adjust the frequency of the microwave field, and that frequency is divided by 9,192,631,770 to get one pulse a second. Simple, right? Number 4. Xion is an anesthetic. Xion is one of the cool silent elements. Well, it's a little bit hard to actually say it at first. but you'll get used to it. Trust me, I'm probably saying that element wrong. Please excuse that. But anyway, not many people know what it's good for. A few people would probably assume it was a planet or something. It is actually a noble gas and can be found in Earth's atmosphere. Xenon can actually be used as an NSEG, and well, as it is a high affinity glycine site NMDA receptor antagonist, there's also a less risk of hypoxia. Hypoxia, the use of xenon. Xenon has an advantage over other NMDA receptor antagonists because of its lack of neurotoxicity. It actually reduces the neurotoxicity of ketamine and nitrous oxide, other more popular anesthetics. Another plus point for xenon is that it is not a greenhouse gas, so releasing it into the atmosphere will not harm it. There's already xenon in the atmosphere, so the atmosphere should not be harmed by the addition of more xenon. It's probably akin to adding more stuff to a pizza. The only people complaining are probably crazy. Number 3. Bismuth can fight diarrhea. Well, that is definitely true. Think about Pepto. If anybody takes Pepto, then guess what? They have some bismuth inside the Pepto. Now, bismuth has been known since ancient times and was confused for other more valuable metals like tin, lead, and even antimony, which is surprising because nobody knows what antimony is. Nowadays, bismuth enjoys a position few other metals do. Gets a place in the medicine cabinet. If you have diarrhea or nausea and had to drink a pink liquid or take a tablet called Pepto-Bismol, then bismuth is greatly alleviated your discomfort. Pepto is the marketing name of bismuth, salicylate, and is a colloid of bismuth, salicylate, with the empirical formula of C7H5Bi04. It works by decreasing the flow of electrolytes and fluids into the bowel. It also kills the organisms that cause diarrhea, so that's feeling good. Whenever we feel the runs coming, we all know who to thank. Well, bismuth does not get enough love for the job it does. Bismuth does a thankless job of soothing your stomach with a wintergreen flavor. Thank you, Pepto. Number 2. Zinc can be a treatment for the common cold. Well, we've already used a lot of zinc. It's in our food, it's a dietary supplement, and it's even in sunscreen lotion. We can't seem to get enough of zinc. There are so many uses for it, and some scientists and researchers think that it could be a remedy for the common cold. Well, guess what? Zinc acetate and zinc gluconate, when taken in lozenge form or as a nasal gel, could alleviate cold symptoms. Scientists are not entirely sure how the zinc works, but results show zinc can be a treatment for the common cold. The symptoms of the common cold, such as discharged, congestion, sneezing, coughing, and others, were shown to have been reduced by varying percentages when the subject was taken zinc. These may be because of the way zinc affects the pharyngeal region. In fact, zinc was discovered to treat the common cold when a girl with leukemia dissolved a zinc tablet in her mouth and her cold symptoms disappeared. Since then, scientists have been researching zinc. Number 1. Tungsten is used to counterfeit gold. Tungsten comes from the Swedish words called tung and sten, which means heavy stone. Well, it also has the alternative name of wolfram, which is infinitely cooler sounded than tungsten. Wolfram just rolls off the tongue better. The density of tungsten is about 19.25 grams per centimeter three, or per square, or excuse me, per cube centimeter, while the density of gold is 19.3 grams per per cubed centimeter. Because of the closeness of the densities, tungsten can pass off as gold in superficial tests. There are several methods to do this. One is to plate a bar of tungsten with gold. While this scam dates back to the 80s, people still fail it. As recently as 2010, a bank in Germany was fooled into accepting gold plated tungsten bars. Tungsten can be bought for $30 a pound, while the price of gold is larger. Anyway, guys, that is it. Subscribe to this channel, like this video, and see you guys next time.